I am Dr. Kunal Das. I am consultant and head department of gastroenterology, Manipal Hospitals, Dwarka, Delhi. So today's topic of discussion is acute pancreatitis. So acute pancreatitis, as the word means, it is inflammation of the pancreas. Pancreas is an organ which is situated in the base of the stomach, in the side of the duodenum, and has a very important role to play in the digestion, in role in our body. So it helps us to digest the carbohydrates and proteins. So when there is any acute damage to this organ, it is known as acute pancreatitis. The most important symptoms of pancreatitis are, first, there is an acute severe pain in the epigastric region just below the chest bone and above the umbilicus. Sometimes this pain can also radiate to the back. The other common symptoms are vomiting, nausea, distension of the abdomen, non-passage of motions. These are the most important. The way to diagnose this pancreatitis is by doing a blood test, which is by the name of serum amylase, serum lipase. If they are more than 300 units, it is almost diagnostic of pancreatitis. The other investigations which can be used are ultrasound of the abdomen, which can help to see the pancreas, and also diagnose gallbladder stones, which may be associated in this condition. Another test, which is also known as CT scan of the abdomen or Rangin X-ray Pet ka, it is also a very important test. It helps us to grade the pancreatitis, whether the pancreas, how much is the pancreatic necrosis happens, and if there is any fluid collection or pancreatic pseudocyst formation in the abdomen. The most important risk factors for this acute pancreatitis is, number one is alcohol. Taking alcohol causes pancreatitis. Second most common is gallbladder stones. Sometimes there is the gallbladder stones from the gallbladder goes into a duct known as CBD or common bile duct and gets stuck in the end of the pancreatic duct and causes pancreatitis. The other commoner tests, causes of pancreatitis are ERCP, which is a test which is done to remove these CBD stones. As a complication of the procedure, it may happen. Fourth common test are some drugs which may cause pancreatitis. Most of these drugs are antiretroviral drugs or anti-pain drugs. The next most important, sometimes some of them are more genetically inclined for acute pancreatitis. Now, once the diagnosis of pancreatitis has been done, the second step is to find out the severity of pancreatitis. The severity of pancreatitis may be mild, moderate, severe. Is usually assessed by the doing a CT scan of the abdomen. The prognosis of such a pancreatitis is depending upon the severity of pancreatitis. If the pancreatitis is mild, patient is likely to get discharged within a period of 4 to 5 days. If, however, the pancreatitis is moderate on CT, then patient needs maybe admission for 2 to 4 weeks. If, however, the pancreatitis is very severe, then the likelihood of presence in the hospital is 4 to 6 weeks and likelihood of complication is much higher. The complications which may happen with pancreatitis are pancreatic necrosis, pancreatic pseudocyst formation, sepsis. These are the most important pancreatitis complications. And in severe pancreatitis, it's a very serious disease and there is almost 60% mortality. That means if 100 patients of pancreatitis or severe pancreatitis occur, 60% may not live to see the end of the day. So that's how severe pancreatitis is. So friends, so we must be knowing this pancreatitis and we must know the risk factors so that we can avoid them and understand them. So in the end, I will just summarize. Pancreatitis is a disease of the pancreas. And its symptoms are by severe epigastric pain in the abdomen and vomiting and non-passage of stools along with distension of abdomen. Diagnosed by blood test, amylase and lipase, and some other tests like ultrasound and CT scan help us to diagnose. If we know, we can fight with this disease. Thank you very much.